Why value is concerned? Because it's very important how you are communicating. It's very important either you are delivering at the right place or not. आपके कौन कौन से डिपार्टमेंट्स को क्लोज होना चाहिए और कौन कौन से डिपार्टमेंट्स को थोड़ा फासले पे भी हो तो फर्क नहीं पड़ता. यस, आपके कौन कौन से, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, हाउ मच विल यू बी फैसिलिटेटेड इफ योर क्लासरूम्स और योर यू नो लेक्चर्स आर बीइंग कंडक्टेड इन द सेम बिल्डिंग वेयर योर डिपार्टमेंट इज. यस, because you will not need to rush for the projector and you will not need to rush for the markers and dusters and all those things.
Yes.
So this is just an example of layout. Okay, let's put example of McDonald's. Innovation at McDonald's. Now look at different years in which McDonald's is shifting or adding different facilities to its stores. Indoor seating, they started it in 1950s. Drive-through window, 1970s. Only on indoor seating, 1950s. They introduced drive-through windows where you don't need to visit the restaurant inside. You just visit drive-through area and you can order there and get your order from the window over there. Adding great cost to the menu in 1980s. Adding play areas, late 80s. Redesign the kitchens, 1990s. Self-service kiosk, 2004. And now three separate dining sections. These are different additions that McDonald's did in their restaurants. Now look at these additions, look at these innovations that they brought in to their restaurants. 6 out of 7 are layout decisions. 6 out of 7 are layout decisions. For example, indoor seating, layout decision. Drive-through window, layout decision or not? Adding breakfast to the menu? Not. Adding play area? Yes. Redesign of kitchens? Layout decision. Self-service kiosk? Layout decision. And three separate dining section is a layout decision. So you understand how operations is concerned with layout decision? Agree? More are mentioned over here. 7th major innovation. Redesigning all the 30,000 outlets around the world. 3 separate dining areas. And those 3 separate dining areas, kaun se hain? Little zone with comfortable chairs and Wi-Fi connections. Yes? Grab and go zones with tall counters, flexible zones for kids and families. Facility layout is a source of competitive advantage. Do you agree with this? Facility layout is a source of competitive advantage. Competitive advantage means you have some advantage over your competitors, right? So you know, if you look around to different restaurants in your city, why you go to different restaurants? One category is food, quality food. But yes, the other category is the facility layout. It's very important. Why you go to, these big malls? For facility layout. Because you enjoy the facility layout. Otherwise, best food is available over here in Lakshmi, but no proper seating area or no good facility layout over there. That's why you don't go with families over there most of the time. Yes? For example, if you are going to invite your fiancée, so you will not invite her to or him to
Lakshmi Chowk.
Lakshmi Chowk, but you will invite him or her to English Tea House maybe, or Yum's maybe, or whatever good facility layout restaurant is. Layout design considerations. What is the objective? Objective of layout strategy is to develop a cost-effective layout that will meet firm's competitive needs. The important thing is, what is your competitive need? On what grounds do you want to be different from your competitor? Yes? Then, develop a layout strategy that is cost-effective and meet your competitive strategy as well. I mean, it should not be the case that your competitive strategy is different and your layout strategy is different. For example, if you are saying you are the only restaurant in the city which is based on cricket theme, right? Then your everything in the restaurant should reflect cricket. Even your menu should reflect cricket.
Yes.
Maybe it can be with the names of bowlers, with the names of
batsmen,
with the names of keepers, and with the names of umpires. Blah 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 blah. Layout design considerations mein mazid dekhte hain. Higher utilization of space, equipment and people. Improved flow of information, materials or people. Flow of information is very important. This is one of the major concerns for which you do layout study. Yes, this is one of the major reasons for which you go for layout study. Improved employee morale and safer working conditions. Safer working conditions are also very important. Improved customer-client interaction and flexibility. Flexibility for both. Now, what are types of layouts? Office layout, retail layout, warehouse layout, fixed position layout, process-oriented layout, work-cell layout, and product-oriented layout. So we will discuss all these layouts. What is office layout? Positions workers, their equipment and spaces offices to provide for movement of information. At what place which office should be? You know, the offices which are closer to each other should be spaced close to each other. For example, in a university, all admin offices should be at one place because all those offices are linked with each other. Yes? Retail layout. Allocate shelf space and respond to customer behavior. Allocate shelf space and respond to customer behavior. At what shelf space your customer is behaving in what way? Yes? Why you place good things or the things which are new into the market or the things which you want customers to approach at front of your shelf, at the entrance of your retail store. And some restaurants do this. What they do? I mean, you can see Hyperstar and Rahim store or all other big stores. What they do basically, they change location of their products. Why? Have you ever noticed?
Yes, sir.
They change location of their products, their shelves, time to time. For example, you pick rice from shelf number 3 last month. In current month, you will find rice in a different shelf. and use machinery and equipment to focus on production of single product or group of related products. Product oriented layout seeks the best personnel and machine utilization in repetitive or continuous production. Process oriented layout, it's important, that's why I'm repeating this again. Seeks the best personnel and machine utilization. Seeks the best personnel and machine utilization in repetitive or continuous production. It means your process is producing something batch by batch. Right? So for all this production, what you want best utilization of personnel and material and machine. Okay, let's discuss office layout. After that, we will attend this lecture. Office layout. Look at the picture. This is one example of office layout. You see, two persons are sitting over here, one is sitting over here, one is sitting over here, one is sitting over here. One cabinet is over there, maybe a line manager. Right? Some people are sitting over here, some people are sitting over here, and some people are sitting over here. This is on the one floor. Right? But maybe these are different departments. This is one department, this is another department, this is another department. Yes, but for manager, there is some separate space where he can feel this is my separate office. Because he is managing all those things. Grouping of workers, their equipment and spaces to provide comfort, safety and movement of information. Movement of information is the main distinction. Movement of information is the main concern why you want layout to be designed effectively. Yes? Typically, in state of flux due to frequent technological changes. Supermarket layout. Objective is to maximize profitability per square foot of floor space. What is the objective? To maximize profitability per square foot of the floor space. Because there, if you are a successful supermarket, you are a successful retail store, there is a competition for shelf space. There is a competition on shelf space where your product will be displayed and companies used to pay for it to get good shelf space. Sales and profitability vary directly with the customer exposure. What customer exposure? If it's visible to you, you will go for it. If it's not, most probably you will not. Then you will look at alternatives. If alternative is available, you will go for that. So it depends your availability. You like one brand, okay? But that one brand is available only in Alpha Liberty, right? You are residing in surrounding area of GC problem. You can't go every time or every month to Alpha Liberty for that shopping. So if that product is not available in some specific at some specific retail store, it means their sale is affecting. So shelf space is very important and it varies with the customer exposure. Sale and profitability vary directly with customer exposure. Okay. Five ideas for layout of supermarket. Locate high draw items around the periphery of the store. Use prominent locations for high impulse and high margin items. Look at this. Use prominent locations for high impulse and high margin items.
That's why companies used to pay for shelves. Distribute power items to both sides of the aisle and disperse them to increase viewing of other items. Use end aisle locations. Convey mission of store through careful positioning of lead of department. Now look at the store layout. This is one store layout. One end is with the dairy and the other end is with look, meat, fish, cheese, ethnic food, bakery,
produce,
right? Seafood, wine care, dairy, fast food and video section. So what you do basically, and these are counters, right? So what you do basically, you design in such a way, one side is for dairy and the other side is for bakery, right? So what are you looking for basically? Yes? You will see at retail stores or at the counters of different retail stores, there are some things like chocolates, like the things you can pick from the counter and you know placed besides the counter. Why? Because maybe you can't focus on these things when you are moving around the store, because those are you know things which cost less to you. And when you have the complete shopping, you know either you are in your budget or not. So you feel also hungry when you are moving around and blah blah blah, you need energy as well. So you pick up the chocolate or drink or energy drink or anything like that, which you may be hesitated when picking from the main shelves. Manufacturing, this is what I was discussing before. Manufacturers pay fees to retailers to get the retailers to display their product. Right?
Yes.
Contributing factors, what are contributing factors? Limited shelf space and increasing number of new products. Better information about sales through POS data collection. POS is point of sale. Point of sale data collection. Closer control of inventory.